Today we discuss about kingdom Manira. This kingdom, it includes all type of the prokaryotic cell like Archibacteria, Eubacteria, Mycoplasma, and Actinomycetes. These prokaryotic organisms, Archibacteria, Eubacteria, Mycoplasma, and Actinomycetes. These four are included under Monera kingdom. So we have to discuss about the first one, that is Archibacteria. See this. This is the Archibacteria. These are the special monerans. They live in some of the most harsh habitats. Which are live in the salt areas. These are called halophiles. Yes, these Archibacteria which are live in hot springs, these are called thermoacidophiles. These live in marshy areas. These are called methanogens. Here, these Archibacteria cell wall does not contain peptidoglycan. Does not contain peptidoglycan. That is why it is a special type of the bacteria. It does not contain peptidoglycan, but it contains the pseudomurine. That's why the cell membrane contains the branched chain lipids. That way the cell membrane contains branched chain same lipids. This is the future. Is responsible for the survival in the extreme conditions. What is the special feature? It contains the branched chain lipids. The cell wall contains the pseudomurine. This is the most important one in the MCET point of view. That's why you have to remember the Archibacteria cell wall, which is containing the pseudomurine and branched chain lipids. That's why this is the basic feature for surviving in the harsh habitats. So, next one, methanogens. Methanogens are also comes under Archibacteria. These methanogens are also present in the gut of the several ruminant animals like goat, sheep, and cow, buffaloes. Yes, these methanogens are responsible for the production of the biogas. Biogas, that is the methane gas, which is consisting of hydrogen sulfide and CO2 and methane. Yes, these biogas, which is produced from the dung of the ruminant animals, from the dung of the cow or buffaloes. So this is the characteristics of the Archibacteria. In these Archibacteria, we have to remember the special feature. That is the cell wall, which is containing the pseudomurine, and what is that? It contains the branched chain lipids. All of you have to remember. This is the main point, very important point, and it is also. The methanogens are also important point. The methanogens which are occur in the gut of the ruminant animals, and that's why this is the responsible for the production of the biogas. This is the characteristics of the Archibacteria. Then we will enter into the Eubacteria. Yes, this is the Eubacteria. Almost it is a bacteria. See, this is a bacteria are most abundant microorganisms. They occur almost everywhere, which means the air, water, and atmosphere, and on the surface of the organisms, either plants or animals, and inside of the organisms. Yes, that's why these are most abundant microorganisms. Most of the bacteria are heterotrophs. Heterotrophs nothing but it cannot synthesize their own food. It is always depend on the other organisms. Here, in these heterotrophs, some are parasites, some are saprophytes. Parasites, which means it's depend on other organisms for their food. Here, the saprophytes, it's depend on the dead organic matter. That's why they are called the saprophytes. Parasites, which means it's depend on the other organisms for the shelter or food. Here also, saprophytes also, it's depend on the dead organic matter for their food. And the next one, see, this is the based on their shape of the bacteria, they are grouped under four categories. See this, one is a spherical, spherical shape is nothing but the round shape. Here, this is the spherical shape. Example, Coccus bacteria. It is a singular one. Coccus, which means it is a singular one. Plural is cocci. Plural is cocci. And see this. The next shape, that is a rod shaped bacteria. Here it is a rod shaped bacteria. Example is the bacillus. Plural is bacilli. And the comma shaped bacteria, it indicates the comma shape. It indicates comma shape. Here it is comma shape. Comma shaped bacteria. Example is Vibrium. And plural is Vibrio. See this. Spiral. Spiral shaped bacteria. Example Spirilla. Plural is Spirilla. And the next one, the cell wall. Already we discussed the structure of the bacteria in the earlier classes. Now also we have to recall that. And see, this is the cell wall. The peptidoglycan, same one which is made up of the peptidoglycan or murine or mucopeptide. Here, this is the cell wall. This is the cell wall which is which is made up of peptidoglycan. Which is made up of peptidoglycan. Cell wall, it is the outer surface of the bacterial cell, and which is made up of peptidoglycan or murine or mucopeptide. And next one, it is the infolding of the cell membrane. Say this is the infolding of the cell membrane. Here it is the inner membrane, the extension of the plasma membrane. That shows the infolding into the matrix of it in this bacteria, and these infoldings are called mesosomes. And what are the main function of these mesosomes, which means these are participated in the respiration and DNA replication, and it's a major role in the respiration process. And here, coming to the next point, see this. Here the genetic material, see this, how it is it? The genetic material, it is naked. The genetic material is naked, which means there is no nucleus, there is no nuclear membrane. That's why we are calling the prokaryotic organisms. Prokaryotic, which means what? Absence of the nucleus and absence of the nuclear membrane. That's why the DNA, which is present in the naked condition, naked position, that's why we are calling the prokaryotic organisms. Here there is no nucleus, there is no nuclear membrane, and there is no membrane bound cell organelles also, except the ribosomes. Ribosomes only present in the bacteria, and all other cell organelles like ER and other cell organelles are absent in the bacteria. Say this. And next thing is the cyanobacteria also comes under the eubacteria. See, this is the cyanobacteria are the most primitive organisms, and it shows the oxygenic photosynthesis. It shows the oxygenic photosynthesis, which means here they are having the chlorophyll A molecule, which is similar to the plants, and are photosynthetic autotrophs. Photosynthetic autotrophs. Here autotrophs are nothing but what's happened? They synthesize their own food. So yes, that's why here they are often formed blooms. They often form blooms here in polluted water bodies. See, this is the blooms which is the increasing in their population.